How's it going, everybody? AB Rhombus here, aka Abnormal Rhombus. I hope your week's going well. You know what these videos are. This is Vlog Time Friday. It's that time of the week again. I love doing these videos, and I hope to keep bringing them to you for a long time, as long as I can keep coming up with stuff to talk about. You know, there's some weeks that I have an issue coming up with something to talk about, and it's frustrating at times, but there's also times in life where the topics are kind of chosen for me just based off of what's going on in my life. And one of those scenarios happened on Sunday. And I'm not trying to make this Vlog Time Friday a sadder video, but it is somewhat of a hard topic for some people. For other people, they'll question why I even made this video, because it won't make sense to them. But for other people, they'll get that. So I guess what happened to me on Sunday was, the first dog that my family ever had, we got him 14 years ago when I was a freshman in high school. He passed away on Sunday. My mom and sister had to take him to the vet and get him put down. And this is a topic that's really hard for some people, especially all you dog, cat lovers out there. You know, putting down a pet is never an easy thing to do. And I know over the past probably 6 months, because this was probably 6 months in the making, just because, you know, back in October, the vet told us he's got 3 months to live, and here he lived until May, almost May. And it's rough, but, you know, for the past 6 months or so, we were kind of hoping and praying that we wouldn't have to do what my mom did on Sunday and had to put him down, because we would rather him just go to sleep pain-free. And, you know, I think that's hard. We don't want our pets to suffer. And when they get older, things start wearing down, things start getting tired, things start shutting down. And the best thing we can do in that situation is keep our pets from suffering. And going in their sleep just one night would be shocking to the family, but we would know that he, she didn't have to suffer. And unfortunately, that wasn't the case for our old basset hound, Joe. He lost probably 50 pounds in 6 months, to where he weighed 80 pounds at one point. He was down to like 35. He, I guess, gained a lot of tumors and growths on the inside of his body. And, you know, towards the end, he did suffer. From what my parents and sister were telling me, he, I guess, had stuff coming out of his nose, and it was hard for him to breathe. His back legs were giving out every time he tried to walk. I mean, it made sense. It was time. But, you know, I feel terrible for my mom that she had to go through that. Because, I mean, Joey was really the first thing she saw when she woke up in the morning, and the last thing she saw when she went to bed. And that's hard. You know, I didn't spend as much time with Joe as my mom, dad, and sister, just because we got him when I was a freshman in high school. So, you know, after moving out and going to college, after starting my own life after college, you know, I really only got to spend half of his life with him. And that was always something that was special to me, because I felt like me and Joe had a special bond. And he never forgot me. I could go a year without seeing the guy if that happened. And as soon as I walked through that door, he would know who I was and be super excited to see me. And I think that's a really special thing about pets that I guess some people just don't understand, or some people don't have that connection with their pets. And that is, you got a pet, they're always happy to see you. It's like the first time meeting you almost, every time they see you. And they're so loving. I mean, you treat a dog or a cat right, and they will absolutely just return that tenfold. They're just so loyal, so trustworthy, and, you know, they become part of the family at some point. You know, when you bring them into your household, you're taking care of them year after year, it's responsibility and everything, but they are a part of the family. So I know there's going to be some people out there that say, it's just an animal, get over it. And, well, that may be it to you, it's not it to me. That's not the case to me at all. And, you know, I think Sunday was the first time I legitimately was sobbing in probably a good maybe 10 years, maybe. I can't even remember the last time I cried like that. And for me, it wasn't necessarily that Joe was gone. You know, that was hard. That was a very hard situation, but it wasn't the fact that he was gone. It was me having to interact with my family and the fact that they were going through it. I get down when people around me get down. You know, I knew it was Joe's time. I knew I was going to get the call eventually, and I made peace with that. And I always tried to make sure that when I was visiting my parents and sister and such, that I said goodbye to them one last time, because I knew it was going to be one of these times. I knew I probably wasn't going to be there when it was time. And, you know, I made my peace with that. And it's going to be super hard on Sunday when I go see Mom for Mother's Day. Joe's not going to be there. And that's going to be the first time in a really long time that he's not going to be there. And I don't know how I'm going to take that. You know, they buried him out back in the backyard, so probably going to go visit him. You know, I'll probably visit him every time I visit my parents and stuff, but, you know, it's hard. It's a really hard scenario for anybody to deal with, and shame on you if you give somebody a hard time for being upset over a pet. That's ludicrous. Because, you know, it's something that's been a part of their life for a lot of people, double-digit years. 14 years in my case. So, you know, how dare you judge them for how much they cared about a pet. And it may not be a person to you, but it's absolutely a person to us. And, you know, I think when dealing with something like this, there's just no miracle cure to make you feel better, right? It's just something that takes time. There's nothing that anybody can say to you. There's nothing that you can do. I mean, you can try to take your mind off it, but is taking your mind off it the right thing to do? I mean, we're talking about this family member that's been a part of your life for a long time. You're just going to forget about them as a way to cope. I think sometimes you just got to let it out. I mean, I let it out hard on Sunday, especially after talking to my mom on the phone when she was on her way to the vet to do what she had to do. Yeah, I mean, I let it out hard. And yeah, you probably hear me in my voice throughout this, especially the last couple of minutes or so, kind of tensing up a little bit and getting a little high-pitched. You know, it's really hard to talk about. It's really hard to talk about and think about. And, you know, I'm probably going to feel like this for a while. You know, those of you that lost pets, you probably felt like that for a while. And, you know, you just realize that you think about that pet a little bit more, especially in my case where I wasn't really a part of his life as of late, that big part of his life as of late. You know, I found that I've been thinking about him more over the past week. Instead of forgetting about him, I actually put him as my wallpaper on my phone for the past week. And, you know, I think it's helped. You know, I don't think forgetting about him is the right thing to do. I think the right thing to do is whenever you feel like you have to, let it out. No one's going to judge you. A lot of people have been there. And letting it out, I think, is a way of coping with it. It gets a little bit easier every day. And, you know, it's hard. It's absolutely hard. So, you know, in the comments section below, I'd love to hear if you guys had a long time friend and a pet that, you know, passed away recently, maybe not super recently, but hopefully not super recently, but, you know, tell me how it impacted you. Or maybe you're on the other side of the fence where you don't think that we should be upset over losing a pet because it is just a pet. Whether or not I agree with you, that doesn't matter. It's your right to say it and your right to feel about it and your right to comment on my video and say how you feel about it, but just don't judge other people based off of how they feel about it. Say what you got to say, but, you know, leave it at that. And, you know, why don't you share the name of your pet, what type of pet it was, maybe breed, and, you know, let us know a little bit about that friend that you lost, that family member. If you like this video, I know it was a sad one, you know, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to join the Rhombus Rebellion and subscribe to my channel. I'd really appreciate it. And, you know, I hope you guys have a really good Friday. Next week will be better. Catch you later. Peace.